Namaste. In the previous videos, we have seen the different functions of the body are controlled by the nervous system. The brain and the spinal cord, as a part of nervous system, they release the neurotransmitters which transmit the signals from the brain to different organs. They transduce the signals across the cell membranes of every cell, and in response to this signals, the cells perform some actions which become their normal functions. In a way, the brain regulates and controls all the organs in the body. The neurotransmitters are the chemicals which are responsible for executing this control. In this video, we will see how the presynaptic nerve ending is capable of releasing the neurotransmitters. Before the release, they are stored into the vesicles till the signal arrives at the presynaptic nerve ending to release the neurotransmitter. Before storing it into the vesicles, they are synthesized. So, we will see the process of biosynthesis of the neurotransmitter of adrenergic system, that is norepinephrine, the process of its storage and release. Norepinephrine is synthesized from an amino acid which is picked up from the extra neuronal compartment. It is L-tyrosine. This amino acid is picked up in the presynaptic nerve ending and acted upon by an enzyme which is L-tyrosine hydroxylase. This L-tyrosine hydroxylase hydroxylates its phenyl ring, third position over the phenyl ring, to convert it into L-DOPA, that is dihydroxyphenylalanine. This dihydroxyphenylalanine undergoes decarboxylation by an enzyme that is called L-DOPA decarboxylase. L-DOPA decarboxylase removes the carboxyl group from L-DOPA, converts it into dopamine. This molecule, dopamine, is then stored along with an enzyme called beta hydroxylase and one molecule of ATP in the storage vesicles. In response to the arrival of one action potential to the presynaptic nerve ending, the ion channels available in the cell membrane, they become permeable to the calcium divalent ions. These calcium divalent ions penetrate inside the presynaptic nerve ending and they catalyze to activate the beta hydroxylase enzyme. Beta hydroxylase enzyme hydroxylates a position in dopamine and converts it into norepinephrine. The norepinephrine containing vesicles travel and release the neurotransmitter into the synaptic cleft as by exocytosis. In response to one action potential arriving at the presynaptic nerve ending, thousands of molecules of norepinephrine are released into the synaptic cleft. Here, we take an opportunity to pause, think for the content we have seen till now, and write it on a paper. Welcome back. We may now revise the whole process of biosynthesis of norepinephrine. L-tyrosine, an amino acid residue picked up from the extraneuronal compartment at the presynaptic nerve ending, converted into L-DOPA by hydroxylating third position on the phenyl ring. This step is catalyzed by an enzyme L-tyrosine hydroxylase. L-DOPA converted into dopamine by removal of this carboxyl group by the enzyme L-DOPA decarboxylase. Dopamine converted into norepinephrine by hydroxylating this second position on ethyl amine. This molecule is converted into norepinephrine. Now, let us see how norepinephrine is converted into epinephrine. Epinephrine differs from norepinephrine in that the amino group is methylated. This methylation is brought about in the adrenal medulla by an enzyme N-methyl transferase. It methylates this primary amino into a secondary amino group. This is epinephrine. This part has been abstracted from Foy's Principle of Medicinal Chemistry, 6th edition. Thank you.